I assume everybody who's come for this event is here. Welcome everybody, my name is Max Rathmell and I'm chairman of Spenmolly Civic Society. Now this is a little inaugural event because this year, to complement the Luddite statue that we've erected at the corner of Nola Hill, we're launching a Luddite trail footpath around Spenmolly. Information boards and plaques to mark various events that took place in 1812 during the Luddite events 200 years ago. So this is a kick-off ceremony, if you like, to mark a summer of events. The first one will be a plaque that will be fastened on Owens Corning's Mill opposite Hightown School, which is the place where many of the local Luddites worked in a workshop known as Jackson's Cropping Shop that stood where Owens Corning's factory now is. And the managing director from America is coming over to unveil the first plaque to commemorate that event and the people that worked there who met and plotted in the room above the bar in this building during 1812, where they plotted the attack on Rawpole's Mill, Cartwright's Mill at Rawpole's. Now our friends here belong to a group called Frayed Knot from Huddersfield, right, and have come over to help us celebrate this event, which is 202 years since the famous events of 1812. Of course, many of the Luddites, if not most of the Luddites, were actually from Huddersfield. Primrose Lane was fundamentally people from Huddersfield, so we're very pleased, delighted to have people here from Huddersfield joining with us, the local Luddites, to commemorate our events here. Now they're going to a symbolic breaking of the frame in this corner. Right, this is the dreaded machine. Not very sophisticated, I know. But it was a machine that did the work of four men, and this was what all the bother was about up until 1812, or a few years before 1812. Cloth was cropped, i.e. the hairs on the top of the cloth was cropped short by hand. Skilled men using very heavy cropping shears did all this work by hand, but this machine that was being introduced into the mills could do the work of four men. And of course, at that time, if you lost your job, you were destitute because there was no social or anything. It meant starvation. And those machines there meant starvation for many people in Spenmolly at the time. Okay, so these guys and gals are going to storm from this field into here and symbolically smash this machine. Hey. We're in your hands. Thank you very much. Hey. Hey.
Hey.
February 1812, and this will be one of the information boards that we will be putting at Hartsey Crossroads by Hartsey Church. The snow in February, two wagons were coming from Millsbridge, Marsden, bringing sophisticated versions of that machine to Cartwright's mill. The word of the delivery of these machines leaked out, and in this building here, the men plotted to ambush those two wagons with the machines and break the machines. And this was a very successful event as far as they were concerned, because they ambushed the machine somewhere at the top of Hare Park Lane, tied the people driving the horses and the cart, and smashed all the machines in the two wagons. Right, which was what was happening in many other places, breaking into mills and smashing the machines. Okay, well, that's basically it. We're doing a Luddite trail. There's an information board in the bar. There will be some food, I understand. Should appear. Courtesy of Paul, the landlord. You're welcome to come in and have a bit of something to eat.
Just to show.